It's no secret that in the meta, as it stands, units with blast abilities reign supreme. We can take a peek at any meta tier list and see Jingliu and Daniel at the top, disgusting as it may be. However, with the news of a recent change, we may see some light at the end of the tunnel. This change changes everything, and here's why. HSR is a team building game. You generally want to optimize towards clearing a certain piece of content. Now, MOC is pretty much set in stone as to how it will exist. One or two big bosses and you beat them up, bang, pound, done. This allows these destruction blast units to absolutely flourish. They're in peak form because of the tight spread on the large amounts of damage they do. But what if MOC has changed and become something a little closer to farming calyxes for materials? While we're at it, why don't we just call it pure fiction? We would see a complete rewrite of the current tier list, as they couldn't just easily be ported over to this new game mode. These Overcell's blast destruction units would do well, of course, their minor AoE, but their damage to smaller units is just overkill, so there are high potential losses in damage. Where if we could just, I don't know, spread that damage a little more, it would be chef's kiss. This is where Erudition Path rises up. This is where it becomes supreme. To sell you my point, I want you to do a quick thought experiment with me. When you're farming Crimson Calyxes, who do you lean more towards? A beefy Jingyuan or a Daniel? Who is clearing that content faster? I have a clear answer in my books, but what do you think? This is the most important question we'll all have to be asking ourselves, because if clearing Crimson Calyxes was important or a hard task, well, you'd probably want a unit to do it better, faster, and easier. A tale as old as time, it's the same story with MOC. You want the meta units to clear it better, faster, easier. It just makes sense. You want the rewards after all, not to mention, it's fun. You have a playground to throw your units that you've been building at. Poyo, in their infinite wisdom, has decided to not make the players choose between which playgrounds to play in, or even limit their ability to access it. They simply made two different and hopefully equal fun playgrounds. This is a genius move for Hoyo because they're introducing a system that allows Erudition to finally have a home. Seriously, this change will sprout an entirely new tier list because the current ones are based on MOC only. Also, from like a financial side, it's excellent for their marketing because units that are perceived as weak in the current game state are going to be reinvigorated as every unit is now going to be double checked for new viability. During this process, we may even see some new faces on the MOC tier list, as many eyes will be double-checking their work. The keen-eyed may have already noticed it, but I want to call your attention to Argenti. Argenti has already been written off, and that's pretty fair in the game's current state, but with this new game mode that he will be softly launching with, we're already looking at a completely unpredicted future. Argenti is now the S-King of this new game mode, where AoE damage is absolutely supreme. Likely right alongside the Lightning Lord himself. Perhaps if we're lucky, we'll even get to see Himiko up there riding the stars. For me, this is excellent news. I get to make all kinds of interesting content based on these changes, but it's also a little bit of a bummer. These recent videos I've made talking about meta and account progression are going to change with the times. Once I have a better picture of it all, I will make those new videos for everyone's, well, hopefully everyone's, viewing pleasure. As an example, here's a thought. I have some worries about this new game mode, like, how do DOT teams compare? I'm suspecting they'll be like a jack-of-all-trades type of team with no real mastery over a specific game mode, but performing decently well in each. That makes these units even more efficient to acquire and build, if they're duly effective in both and allow you to clear the content. The list goes on, but we have to reassess every team type and every unit with this new mode. This is a bit shorter one for me. I just want to get my thoughts out there. And if you like what you heard, you should subscribe. This is what I do. So if you like HSR content and maybe you're looking forward to ZZ, I'm going to be making content on both games in the near future. So thanks for watching. And that's all for me. So see you.